To change the appearance of the in-game HUD and touch interface for your platformer game, you'll be working in the layout called Level UI Layers. Click the Layers tab and unlock either of the two layers you want to edit. Once either layer is unlocked, you can move the individual graphic elements such as the touch buttons, lives counter, health stars, etc. If you double-click on any element in an unlocked layer, the frame editor will appear so you can edit or replace the graphics or collision shape for that object. While all these objects currently use a single static image, feel free to replace them with animations by importing or creating the multiple frames, setting the animation to loop, and adjusting the playback speed of the entire animation or specific frames accordingly. If you look above the layout area in the HUD layer, there are two sprites. These are the buttons that appear when the game is paused. Double-click on them to edit or replace their animations. The first several frames are for an appearance effect, and the final frame is set to loop. The background frame for the in-game dialog box is made with a 9-patch object. Just double-click it to edit the image it uses. The 9-patch object automatically tiles the corners and all four sides of the single image in order to create the full background frame. Two separate sprite font objects are used, one for in-game dialog and one for the lives counter. If you'd like to replace the fonts with one that better matches the style you want for your game, we recommend you use the free tool called SpriteFontGenerator, which you can find in the Construct Community forums. We'll provide the link below. You can copy and paste the character set from the sprite font properties to the sprite font generator, or vice versa if you need to add more characters for your game or language. Just double-click to load in your new sprite font sheet image. You can then find the Fonts Setup event sheet, find the setup event for the particular sprite font object you've updated, and paste in the new JSON font spacing that the font generator tool created for you. Thanks for watching.